Hello people, let's see how to put effects and transitions with Pinnacle Studio 17. Correct us in comments if you find mistakes in pronunciation. Let's see how to put effects. As you know, you have different kinds of files. The effects for visible parts are different than the audio ones. Let's suppose to edit a picture. If you double click on it, you will open the editor window used to edit and add effects on it. On the center you have the preview and its player. The timeline shown refers to the main timeline occupied by the clip opened. More at the bottom you have the navigator that shows you all the clips in your main project. If you click on the rectangles, you will go and open these other clips. Then, on top, you have the full list of things you can apply to the picture. You have different sections, and each one shows, if selected, its full list inside. It is numbered, but don't mind about their order. One section is corrections, used to enhance the appearance and the colors of the picture and adjust its sides. Just select the kind of correction first. The ways to set an adjustment can change, but don't worry, they are easy to use. Pan and zoom is used to move and zoom in out the file respect to the project view, often used to create fast PIP effects. If you are interested in picture-in-picture effects, watch the related video in our guide. You can choose to adjust a fixed zoom or make it animated. In this case, you will have to set two contours, the green one, which is the starting point, and the red one, the final point. Try it. Then you have effects that, instead of enhancing or correcting the picture, it can distort or change the photo appearance. In this case, if you click on a subsection, another list appears. If you hover an effect, you will see below a straight example of it. So you can choose between different groups of effects, 2D, 3D, stereoscopic, and so on. Each one of them has a full list of similar effects. So camera adjusts the kind of picture, artistic gives a new point of view, and so on. Click on one of the effects to edit more on the right. The effects added are all listed below, with their names and with some icons on the right. The bin button is used to delete the effect. Press Ctrl and Z to undo this. The orange square indicates that the effect is on and applied. If you click on it, you will put it off. If you click on the small node next to effects on top, you will enable and disable all the effects listed below and applied on the picture. Not always the effects order doesn't count. Sometimes, if you change it, the final effect can be affected. To change such order, just drag one of the effects and pull it up or down. The effect on top of the list is the first one to be applied in your picture. Once an effect is selected, all its options will be listed more at the bottom. With this, you can find how the effect must appear. As long as you set effects in this way, they will remain static, so they won't have properties changing in time. The first icon on the right enables the keyframes. Keyframes are points fixed in time that define a determined set of properties for the effect interested. In this way, two keyframes following that have different effect properties saved create an overall effect that changes in time between the first keyframe and the second one. By default, you already have one keyframe that you can move in another instant of time by dragging it. As long as the playhead is on the keyframe, you can edit the effect properties that the keyframes has to save. Then, to add another keyframe, simply place the playhead in another instant of time and change the properties. If you play your work, the effect will change, passing from the properties of the first keyframe to the second ones. Remember that you can delete a keyframe right-clicking on it, and if you want to return to the static effect, simply click again on the rhombus icon. Remember that each effect has its own independent set of keyframes. When you are done, just go to OK. The effects added are represented as colored lines on top of the clip. Pink is for the effect section, green for the corrections section. To delete fast these effects, right-click on such lines, select the section and go to delete. The effects available do change in case you have to do with text or audio clips. If you want to know more about text and titles, watch the related video in this series. If you have audio clips, you can add effects in the same way, using Editor. In this case, the preview will show you the sound waveform and the channel mixer on the left. There is also a volume bar, measured in dB. If you notice that the track reaches red levels, just turn it down. In the bottom right corner, you choose to see the time waveform or the frequency spectrum of the audio clip that tells you the intensity of each frequency band. Here you can find again corrections, in this case to adjust and make better sounds. Effects that changes the way to feel such sound, for example if you want to apply reverb or echo. Then the way to manage them on the right is the same as seen for the effects applied on pictures. Audio effects can't be applied on some tracks that come from Pinnacle Studio, for example the ones from Score Fitter. Audio volume can be also adjusted activating the audio levels button above the timeline. Each track will show a dB meter, so the maximum level of the output sound on each of them. Be sure to have all the tracks below the red level, or their sound will be distorted. You can use the first orange knob to adjust the master volume of the whole track, affecting all its clips inside. Otherwise, you can use the right green knob. Instead of using this knob, simply use the green line on the sound parts of audio clips or videos. This changes the volume of the single clip, not on the whole track. Just pull it down to lower the volume. What about video clips with sound? These have inside audio and visible parts. If you double click on them, The editor window shows you, in the top left corner, video and audio, so you can choose to edit the video frames themselves or the audio part instead. So, if you have video selected, you will apply effects and corrections on the clip. You won't find all the effects seen. For example, you don't have pan and zoom here. If you click on audio instead, you will find all effects and corrections seen for audio clips, all the same. If you want to add fast effects, you can use the navigation panel as well. Open effects folder in case of videos and images. Then simply click and drag the interested effect and drop it on the clip. But if you want to personalize it, you will have to use the editor window as seen. In case of sound effects, the sound effects folder in navigation doesn't list the effects seen in the editor window. It simply collects tracks of noises of animals from the environment and so on. How about transitions? You can apply a simple and fast transition dragging the edges on the clips when the pointer changes shape approaching the corners. In case you apply transitions on videos, text and pictures, this will apply the fade in at the beginning and a fade out in the end, where the clip appears and disappears. The more you drag, the more the transition lasts in time. If you want to personalize your transition, you can do it with the editor window, using the transition in and the transition out sections. But in this case, the navigation panel's approach is much easier and faster to be used. If you open the transition folder inside the navigation list, you will have a long list of transitions for visible clips. Just click on the play button to check them through the preview. Then, simply click and drag one on the simple transition just built, and you are done. If you need to remove the transition, just right-click and go to Transition Remove. In case of sound clips, the transitions work on the volume level, so the sound clip increases or decreases its volume intensity. Mind that, in case you want to put transitions on sound parts of a video, you may need to use the green line seen before. You can adjust it, pulling up or down. But if you right-click on it, you can add keyframes that you can set as the ones seen in the editor window. In this case, drag horizontally to change the time placement and vertically to change the volume that the waveform must show at such instant of time. Keyframes here are represented as green squares. These transitions seen are single-side transitions that are done with a single clip. If you want to make a transition between two clips, just put them close enough. Thanks for watching this video. Discover our full guide for more about Pinnacle Studio 17.